I have sent you all off on your holidays, as you will remember, not at the expense of the BBC, but my own personal expense I have sent you. So there's a special prize of a half-day holiday if you can report on the most interesting thing in the country that I've sent you to visit. Mm. Rob, you should start. Where did I send you? Where did you go?
You sent me to Hungary.
Hungary?
Yes.
Because it had to begin with an H, of course.
Had to begin with an H. That was the fiendish plan, very fiendishly clever. And I went to Hungary, Stephen.
Were they wearing trousers as tight as that?
They were... Well, I was, interestingly enough.
You did?
I Good. Wore trousers very much like that, and with the long sock, of course.
We know about your long socks.
Don't we just? Yeah. I went to Hungary, and I'll tell you what I brought back for you.
Yes.
Curious.
Ooh.
Interesting. What am I
no
showing
gloves.
You?
Yeah.
No gloves.
I know.
Jazz
you're
hands.
A really bad glove puppet.
glove puppeteer who really has lost the plot.
Yeah. Naked glove puppetry.
No. Very, very clean hands.
Clean hands.
Yes.
Hungary. Can we think of a connection?
Are they jumped up in the corruption tables or something? Is that a sort of a euphemistic?
It's very literal. Very literal.
Oh. Ooh.
They don't wipe their bums.
No.
Oh!
I don't think there's a need for that, Aaron. I don't think there's a need for it.
Obsessively washing their OCD.
I do think there's a need to wipe your bottom, by the way. What I was saying is I don't think there's a need for you to say wiping bottoms. Not clean pair of hands.
Yes.
Think, if you will, of medicine for a moment. Where might I be going with this? Medicine... The obstruction is very helpful.
Surgeons.
The importance of surgeons having clean hands.
Scrubbing up, they call it,
don't
they?
Thank you, Stephen. Yeah. Scrubbing up, as Stephen scrubbing says, up. Yes. Yeah. That's it. Opening doors and taps.
Doing the taps like that, they do.
Yeah. Before you know it, you've got a Eurovision act, haven't you? Look at that.
Especially you've got these on, they look...
For a long time, they didn't realise, doctors and surgeons didn't realise, that it was actually very important to wash your hands before you operate, because they weren't aware of the transference of germs. And it was Ignaz Semmelweis, a Hungarian, and he came up with this theory, because he was at the Vienna Infirmary, you see. I've never sounded this knowledgeable on this show.
It's very impressive.
He started this whole idea of the importance of cleanliness and hygiene.
You're absolutely right. There is a museum in Budapest, to which I have been, called the Semmelweis Museum, which is where he lived. He died in poverty and insanity, in fact. I think he died in an insane asylum. No one recognised the absolute truth of what he said.
So excessively clean hands actually drive you mad?
Well, no, what drives you mad is telling the truth and having nobody believe you. See, doctors couldn't face the fact
that
he was basically saying that the thousands and thousands of deaths that took place in hospitals were probably the fault of doctors.
It implied they were a little unclean, didn't it?
Yeah, exactly. But what else has Hungary given us?
Goulash.
Goulash?
Yes.
What does goulash mean? Do you know?
Goulash means stew of some kind.
Well, in Hungarian, it actually means... Do you know what's
It actually means cowboy. I learned this while
cowboy.
I was... Cowboy.
Cowboy. Cowboy, you're right.
Ride 'em, goulash.
Sorry, it's just quite seductive when you press that... When you press that heart button, it's like we're going back in time.
Yes.
Well, tell us, Rob.
1974, and goulash means cowboy.
You're quite right.
No, it means cowboy. The Rubik's Cube, of course, also comes from...
Rubik was a Hungarian. What do they drink in Hungary?
They drink...
Bull's blood.
Bull's blood, you're right. And bull's blood was responsible for one invention, which was not credited. In fact, the very word tells you who we think invented it. No, pasteurisation. Oh. It was not Louis Pasteur who first thought of that. It was an Hungarian, but he wrote a paper on it that was in Hungarian and nobody else in the world read it, because it's a very, you know, almost a unique language.
The other thing that Hungary is famous for, of course, is Laszlo Biro with the ballpoint pen. He also invented the automatic gearbox.
Yes, he sold it to the Ford Motor Company, didn't he? Mm. Yeah, that's right, biro.
There's a lot more to Hungary than meets the eye.
My grandfather.
So why not visit when you get the chance? Hungary, there's so much going on.
My grandfather was born in Hungary.
Really?
Yep, they used to say a Hungarian is the only man who can follow you into a revolving door and come out first.
Isn't there something about the language is uniquely odd?
Well, it's unlike almost all European languages.
But it's related to a language that's miles away.
Finnish and Estonian.
Suomi,
yes. Yeah, the Finnish language. Known as...
When you say Finnish, do you mean the people or the dishwasher tablets? tone, isn't it?
It is, you're so right.
To really get to grips with it. I prefer the liquid.
Power ball. If you get all the power balls out,
yeah,
you can sell them to teenagers at a disco for 20
minutes. Wow. They don't get high, but their insides are fantastically clean.
Yeah. Wow.
Yeah, when they get to the toilets, they clean them.
Yeah. Well done. No, well done, Rob. That's excellent. I'm going to give you a lot of points on that. Rob went to Hungary, where they invented washing your hands, pasteurization, the Rubik's Cube, which you mentioned, and arguably the word hello. Did you know that?
Because of the telephone.
Yes.
Edison's...
One of his assistants.
Assistants went, yeah. Halom.
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 Which is the...
Halom.
Halom means I can hear you.
Yeah.
In I hear you.
I'm not so sure if... I think that sounds a bit fanciful to me.
Yes.
Not that it means I can hear you. The fact that that might then...
Yeah. Have caused us to use
hello.
The word hello on the phone.
I'm not buying that.
Okay.
Which is why I didn't bring it up.
Yeah, fair enough.
I used to collect stamps for about 6 months when I was 11. Mm. And you could send off for packets of stamps.
Yes, I remember.
About 40p or something.
Yeah. Mm.
And you would get lots and lots of...
Triangular ones and
that I called Magyar stamps, but apparently they're
Modra.
Those ones. You'd always get loads of those. They must have printed a lot of stamps, or... Yeah. No one was sending any letters there. Or maybe.
I collected stamps for a very brief period, like you, as my early teens,
too.
And I gave it up. I thought to myself, philately will get me nowhere.
Rob, so quickly, press
Go back in time.
Go back in time.
I collected stamps for a period when I was an early teenager. I loved it.
Yes, it's good. Well done. Good news. So, Hungary, great success, lots of points.